हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू दिस टुडेज एपिसोड ऑफ माय प्रोग्राम। वेल, आफ्टर 3 वीक्स टॉकिंग कंसेक्यूटिवली अबाउट वीमेन ऑथर्स, आई थिंक इट इज़ टाइम फॉर चेंज। सो आई हैव चोजन टुडे टू टॉक अबाउट प्रबोध चंद्र बंदोपाध्याय द ऑथर। डज द नेम मीन एनीथिंग टू यू ऑल? आई एम अफ्रेड नो। But if I say it is Manik Bandyopadhyay that we are going to talk about, then what happens? I'm sure the Bengali audience would be familiar with the name of Manik Bandyopadhyay. So in the next few minutes, we will see how Prabodh Chandra Bandyopadhyay became Manik Bandyopadhyay, and he was considered to be one of the most important authors of Bengali literature in the period of 1930s to mid-1950s. Manik Chandra Bandyopadhyay or Prabodh Chandra Bandyopadhyay was born in Dumka, Bihar in 1908, published his first story in 1928 and continued to write till the time of his death at the age of 48 in 1956. So what we find is, during a period of 28 years, Manik Bandyopadhyay has written 36 novels, 250 to 300 short stories, many essays and a few poems. He is considered to be one of the most important authors of Bengali literature and has also started his own distinctive style. According to his own words, he was a pen-pushing laborer, as in his entire adult life, he earned his livelihood by his writings. Now let us see how the name Manik Bandyopadhyay came and when did he start writing. The year was 1928 and Manik was still in college. At that point of time, one of his friends challenged him to publish a short story in Bichitra, which was the leading periodical of those days and published the works of renowned authors only. What Manik did, he wrote his first short story, named it as Otoshi Mami, and put it in the letterbox of the magazine and signed it as Manik Bandyopadhyay. So Prabodh Chandra Bandyopadhyay took the pen name of Manik Bandyopadhyay. To everybody's surprise, the story was published in Bichitra after a gap of 4 months and created a big sensation in the literary circle of Bengal. Manik Bandyopadhyay has arrived, and then there was no looking back for Manik. What did Manik Bandyopadhyay write, and why did the readers like him so much? Critics say that Manik was actually influenced by two theories. The first one is the Sigmund Freud's theory and the second one is the Marxist theory. He did away with the conventional style of writing and adopted his own style. Instead of writing about the urban middle class, Manik wrote about the wretchedness and the poor, pitiable condition of the rural poor, and he also was very curious and used the dark alleys of human mind in apparently simple village folk to a great extent in his stories. Manik's style was followed later on by his contemporaries and as well as the later generation. So now let us see what sort of writer Manik considered himself to be. Was he a predominantly short story writer or was he a novelist? Let us see what he has to say about that. Quoting from Manik, "There is a thrill in creating short stories and I have to concentrate deeply to create one. Since I have to move at a very fast pace. The mind pace the mind while creating short stories cannot rest. While writing a short story, I sense a thrill at all times. Later on in another essay, he has written that in each novel there is the material for several short stories. Judging by whatever Manik has written, we feel that Manik was a little bit tilted towards the short story mode. But the fact remains, as per the critics, Manik is adept at both novels and short stories. His important novels are, few of his important novels are Podda Nodir Maji or The Boatman of River Podda, Putul Nacher Itikatha or The Puppet's Tale, Shortolia Sabarbia, Chotushkon, etc. His famous short stories include Shorisrip, Otoshi Mami, Choto Bokulpure Jatri, Pragoitiyashik, and many, many more. According to the critics, Manik had two phases. The first phase was definitely Freudian, and during this period, Manik had used the human sexuality and lust in many of his stories. The second phase is from 1944 onwards, when he became the member of the Communist Party. This is the Marxist phase, and this continued till the very end. Apart from this, independence movement, partition, and subsequent riots also played a part in Manik's writings. Manik had used both colloquial and formal language expertly, and has very effortlessly moved from one to the other. According to many, he is the most important writer in Bengali literature after Rabindranath Tagore. Having spoken about Manik's writings and the various aspects that influenced his writings, now I would be talking a little more about one of his short stories. To go into little deeply, I have selected his famous short story Pragoitihashik, or if we translate it, it is clearly says it is prehistoric. This story was written in 1930s and it is definitely Freudian in nature. Here is how the story goes. And before talking about the story, I would also have mentioned that the main character and hero, etc., are the people of the lowest rung as per Manik's tradition. The story opens with Bhikkhu, who is very seriously and grievously injured, coming in one dark rainy night to his friend Prahlad in a small village and seeks the help of Prahlad. Bhikkhu has been involved in an armed robbery which had failed, and all his associates have been captured by the police, and Bhikkhu has just barely managed to escape by murdering one of the house residents, with the police chasing him all the way through. He somehow has reached Prahlad. Prahlad, seeing his wound, decides to help him and hid him in a jungle. But after seeing the wound, he is of the opinion that the wound is serious and Bhikkhu may not survive. However, against all odds, Bhikkhu survives. And at this time, what Prahlad does is to bring him to his own residence so that he can be better taken care of. As Bhikkhu heals, it is very evident that he has lost the use of his right arm. With his strength coming back a little, what does Bhikkhu do? Here is the darkest side of human nature. Bhikkhu lusts for Prahlad's wife. Seeing this, Prahlad throws Bhikkhu out of his house, and before escaping for revenge, Bhikkhu sets fire to Prahlad's house and the house is destroyed, although no life is lost. Having run away from Prahlad's house, Bhikkhu ends up in a slightly bigger space. Here, by displaying his useless right arm, he starts the second chapter of his life as a beggar. As a beggar, he earns little bit money and also has a shelter where he can live. And slowly Bhikkhu started regaining his strength. But a particular character like Bhikkhu, who has spent all his adult life in the world of crime, is not satisfied in the tame life of a beggar, and with recovery of his strength, his lust and sexuality also comes up. He lusts for women's company, and what he does is he goes and approaches a woman beggar who he has seen begging nearby. But the woman refuses Bhikkhu, as she is staying with another beggar called Bashir. Bashir is a very strong guy, although he is lame in one leg, but Bhikkhu also is a daredevil, and Bhikkhu goes and approaches Bashir. There is exchange of words, but somehow Bhikkhu is not able to make much headway with Bashir, and the stalemate remains for some time. After a few days, the lust becomes unbearable for Bhikkhu, so what does he do? He comes out of his shelter and enters the shanty of Bashir and the woman and murders the sleeping Bashir. And he also mocks the dead man. In this melee, the woman wakes up and finds that Bhikkhu has already murdered her mate. Bhikkhu proposes to the woman that you come with me and we will go away from here and start a new life. The woman reluctantly agrees and they move out of the shanty. At first, both of them in the dark night, they are walking together. Then Bhikkhu asks the lady to ride on his shoulders. So carrying the lady, Bhikkhu moves away in the dark night like a prehistoric figure. The story ends here, and it clearly shows us the dark, dark side of human nature in the lowest rung of the society, along with the physicality that is also displayed in the writing. This is vintage Manik Bandyopadhyay. For those of you who would be interested in finding out how he wrote during his second phase, that is the Marxian phase, I would suggest you read his famous short story Choto Bakulpure Jatri, which will give you a very good idea about his writing in the second phase. Before I conclude for the day, I would like to tell you that there are lot of telefilms based on short stories and novels of Manik Bandyopadhyay available in the YouTube. I would definitely suggest that you, apart from reading those books of Manik Bandyopadhyay, you can have a look at those short films and telefilms. This will give you an idea about the works of Manik Bandyopadhyay. Also, I would like to tell you all that in case you feel that you would be interested in any particular author, you can say, let me know. I will try to make an episode if I am familiar with those authors. In fact, this Manik Bandyopadhyay episode was actually as per the suggestion made by one of my friends, and this episode is for that person. Thank you all. See you soon.